or the way of living for God is so complex, who has tricked you or beguiled you? The same words that were used in the Garden of Eden. Because if you'll remember, God created and things were beautiful. Amen?
Amen.
God created and things were beautiful. Guess what? God created you. God created you. Now look, we're as unique can be. You look around this congregation, we have a wide variety of different types of people. But you know what? Each one is beautiful. Amen.
Amen?
Amen. And I don't have to put on some kind of rose-colored glasses to see that. Why? Because God created you, and you know what? He esteems you higher than the lily.
Right.
What lily did He die for? What flower of the field did He die for?
Us.
You know? It was us. It was us. And when you consider the fact that the Lord loves us more. He loves us. He tries to get that across in things like the sparrow. He knows when each one of them falls. How much more does He? He created that sparrow to fly. And so for Him to know when one falls, it's not being or doing what it was supposed to do. He notices. And He notices when you are not living up to your potential in Him.
Right.
And He calls to you. And He calls to you. And He says, come. Come closer. Come closer. Let me show you more. Because if you will learn of me, my way is easy. It's not that there is not a yoke. There is a yoke. There is a cross to be bear, to be born. And I understand that comes with a little difficulty in the mind's eye. But I want to tell you something. Jesus said He'd never leave us or forsake us.
Right.
And that He would be with us always, even to the end. So when you think you're about to stumble or about to fall, remember a scripture that you can trust the Lord or that His yoke is easy. And you say, well, Lord, it doesn't feel easy. Why doesn't it feel easy? Learn of Him.
Right.
Learn of Him.
Right.
We have so many examples in the Bible of people who were going through rough times, but they did some of the strangest things. You look at Paul and Silas, they were in prison, and they started singing.
Right.
Praises.
Right.
At midnight.
Yes.
Now, if I were conformed to this world's way of thinking, I would think it's dark, Lord. Mm-hmm. Oh, woe is me. I don't have my freedom. I don't have my life. I'm in stocks. But you know how. And before you know it, you're beat down. Right? But they had something that this world doesn't have, and so do you. They had a Creator who loved them more than anything. More than anything in this world, the Lord loves you and wants to see you succeed. Wants to see you succeed as an individual, as a believer, as a minister. Now, in John chapter 6 and verse 44, there's a scripture that says, no man can come to me except the Father which has sent me draws him, and I will raise him up in the last day. How many of you have felt insufficient at being able to lead people to the Lord? Amen. Amen. You don't know what to say. Lord, I don't know what to say. Now listen, this is brass tacks. Brass tacks. Listen. If you will naturally be what God has created you to be, it will happen naturally. It will happen. I began to think of the lily and how that it grows up and it blossoms. And you see these little things that these aren't lilies, are they? No. you see these little things right here? They have chemicals, and they have a look that naturally attracts the pollinators, where they multiply because something naturally draws the bee or the insect, or by the wind, or by simply falling to the ground. They naturally reproduce. Friends, when you adopt the philosophy that you can trust the Lord, that you can believe in Him, that He created you to be something, you will naturally reproduce by the Spirit of God. And what I'm talking about is because what happens is when you begin to walk in the anointing that comes with realizing that you can trust in God in all circumstances and that you were created for something, it gives you an authority that you didn't realize that you had before. When you realize that God did not create you to be downtrodden and discouraged and depressed, and when He didn't create you to be dishonest and sinful, He didn't create you to be something that was worthless. He created you to be somebody that was worth something.
That's right.
And you know what? I believe in you. I believe in these kids. I believe in our youth. I believe in this church. I believe that the Word of God will come through in your life. I believe that Jesus will deliver what He's promised. I believe that God can and will do great and mighty things through the individuals who will surrender their lives to Him.
Amen.
He says, "You'll find me if you seek me with all of your heart." The Lord doesn't want us to be half-hearted about our commitment to God. A lot of times we say, "Oh God, I'll give you my all, but this. I want to keep this." I don't want you to keep anything back today. I want you to trust in the Lord.
Yes.
You know, this world might tell you that you can't trust in anybody, and even churches. You know, I think a lot of people, if we don't confess our faults to one another because we can't trust anybody to keep their mouth shut.
That's right.
You know what? That needs to change.
Mm-hmm.
That needs to change. And it, people won't give because they can't trust where the money's going. That needs to change.
Right.
That needs to change. Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Amen.
And don't lean to... You know, a lot of times I want to figure it out. I'm a logical thinker. I want to figure it all out. You know, and you know what? I want instant maturity. I saw somebody asking the question the other day, isn't there some way we can just get to maturity? And there's not. This is the way God created it. You know, as I was ministering to the youth yesterday, the Lord just out of my belly began to tell them, it's your turn. It's your turn now. It's your turn to hear from God. It's your turn to be a Christian. It's your turn to advance this cause. It's your turn. You know, I'm having my turn right now.
Right.
But I realize that my turn doesn't last as long as I thought it would.
Right.
Come on now.
That's right.
Now, I don't consider myself old, but I'm getting older. Brother Bucky was complaining about all the work he had to do yesterday. He said his body doesn't function as well as it used to because he's an old man now. And he doesn't bounce back as quick. I'm the same way. When I hit the ground, I don't bounce as high and don't get up as quick. It's their turn. It's their turn. You know, and we have to... I wish that I could be...